Today, Kevin and I are gonna be opening a package from Arlen, from Claire. Actually, I've already torn it open, but I haven't looked at anything, so it's a lot heavier than what I was expecting.
Oh, fudge.
I sounded like Ralphie in A Christmas Story. Oh, fudge. These are the Cadbury Highlights. She had sent me some of these before, but not the fudge variety. I've never had these before, so that'll be awesome. And the caramel, this is the one that she sent me before, and they are really, really, really good. And I guess this is a different one. Options, Belgian Chalk Mint. And this is only 38 calories. These are 39, the Cadbury. So this'll be a mint drink. That'll be really good. And these are powdered like hot chocolate.
Yeah.
Hot chocolate. What is that?
Rhubarb.
Sugar-free Marks and Spencer. Sugar-free rhubarb and custard drops. That will be completely new. Sustainable for vegetarians. Excessive consumption may cause a laxative effect. a lot of things say that. Hey, that's okay.
And sugar free.
Yeah, that's okay. Dr. Oetker Mug Cake Chocolate Chip. It's new. That looks awesome. You know, a lot of people have recipes on Pinterest and stuff like that for these cakes that you make in mugs, and we've never done that before. So that'll be really cool. I like that.
It's in the fudge.
Lots of fudge. An Angel Delight. We just opened the box from Sarah in England, and she had sent us like two of these. These are so good. I'm gonna have plenty of Angel Delight, the butterscotch.
She sent you a card too, I don't know.
Look at the card! Look!
I don't know what you wanted to show.
That's hilarious.
And a map. She sent us a map to Dublin. I like that sweater.
Okay, apparently there's some squirt bottles in there.
Okay.
She said the Robinson squirt bottles I thought would be fun for Andrew to try because I know he likes adding flavor to his water. I'm the very same. It is also very low calorie per serving and sugar free. I went to Marks and Spencer's to find some unusual things because they always have crazy finds. Marks and Spencer's is a supermarket chain here, and it's also in England. I know you and Kevin will love it when you take your trip. I do plan on going to a grocery store because I would like to try some of the Cadbury ice creams that we can't get here. What? Kevin's gonna read. You have to read it out loud if you're gonna read, if it's about stuff in the box.
I don't want you to read that.
Oh.
It'll be a surprise.
Percy Pig! Soft gums made with fruit juice. No artificial colors or flavors. I can't wait! They remind me of Peppa.
What's he kind of like?
So cute! You know, Gavin would like that too. We could call them Peppa Pigs, and Gavin would really like those. Look, because you can see their little snouts and stuff in there. That's so cute. Okay. Flavins. Microwave Quick Oats Lemon Curd.
Oh, here's the squirt stuff.
She wrote the calories. 150 calories. Lemon curd. I have never had lemon curd oatmeal. So that'll be interesting. For the perfect porridge. I can't wait.
This is like Jell-O. They call it jelly there, but it's like Jell-O.
Chivers sugar-free strawberry flavored jelly crystals. And so we have strawberry and raspberry. And this is Jell-O?
I'm assuming so. It says to add it to water.
Or is this the drink mix?
No, it says to add it to bowl or jug, add boiling water and stir in
the refrigerator. It's like Jell-O. Okay, it's like Jell-O. Okay. These are the squirts.
Yeah.
Robinson's squash.
No, the squirts is what you get when you eat these rhubarb things.
Robinson's squashed. Summer fruits, no sugar added. We will have to have Andrew try
these.
They're both strawberry, yes. Because Andrew will probably like those.
Clotted cream. Yeah, something like about the word clotted doesn't make me want to eat it.
British clotted cream and strawberry fudge. Deliciously soft fudge made by experts with Dorset clotted cream and strawberry pieces. I can't wait because that's something that we've never had.
I'm trying to get things in
and it's supposed to be wonderful. Taste of the British Isles. Oh, Sarah just sent me a smaller one of these. It's like half the size of this. Cadbury Dairy Milk Ritz. I had wanted to try these so bad for so long, and I can't wait because we love Ritz crackers. I guess she put it in the plastic because she was afraid it would melt. McVitie's Medley Hobnobs. Now this is a hobnob bar.
Mm-hmm. Double chocolate. And she gave you the calorie stuff too.
Because Sarah just sent us an actual package of hobnobs, which was heavy. Do you remember it weighed a ton? And so that's cool. I'll get to try that biscuit in bar form. That's cool.
I'm gonna rub it around where you can see both of them.
Okay. M&S. The crunchy one, a chocolate center studded with crunchy honeycomb, caramelized hazelnuts, cornflakes, and wafer. And the crazy one is milk chocolate bar bursting with butterscotch pieces, toffee popcorn, and popping candy.
Definitely.
Two candy bars. I will take good pictures of these when we do the review.
That looks cool.
Chocolate puddings, Christmas pudding flavored chocolate truffles, and they're beautiful.
They are pretty.
They're very pretty, yeah. They're in a, I like these bags. Mm-hmm. Something smells, I guess it's these. That is so neat. These are really, really pretty.
And this looks bag full of roses?
Roses, yes, and Sarah sent me some roses. We've never had roses before, but if they're anything like the Quality Street, oh, I love those. Those are so good. And what is this?
That's yours.
Can I open it?
Yeah. She said she added something for you.
Okay.
I'm assuming this is, yeah. She said, I added a little necklace for yourself. I am forever admiring your silver one that you wear often in the video. So when I saw this, I had to pick it up.
Oh.
I really hope you like it.
Now, what is this liquid?
I don't know. The rock. It changes color based on your mood, your cream, your success.
I don't know. Does it say anything on the back?
Wish pearl.
But it's so pretty.
So you're supposed to open it? You have to open that. That's like a clam or oyster or whatever. You open it. And then you get the pearl out of it. Yeah. Of course I can't read. Oh. Pick up the wish pearl and then the color is pull out the necklace, open the pendant.
And you put that
inside.
In the that's so neat.
Mollusk. Open the mollusk. Make
Isn't
a wish and open
neat?
The mollusk and put it inside the little basket. That's cool.
Oh, wow. We'll do that on a video.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that is so neat. Yeah, I don't think they have anything like that around it. They have something like this at Disney, but.
Yeah, they make a lot of noise. And the Japanese pavilion.
Yeah, the loud. Japanese pavilion. So what it is. There's the mollusk and you open it up and it has a little
pearl
on the inside and then you put it in there. That is so neat and it's one of those colors. Thank you very, very much.
And then that's the rest of it.
Oh, thank you. Yes, Claire. Thank you so very much. I love that. That's so cool.
That's neat. It's different.
We'll definitely, do you want to do it for a video by itself? Probably.
You'll put this as a part of the blog, won't you?
Yeah, this will be in a vlog. This will be on Monday's vlog, probably with Thanksgiving and everything. Everything that's going on this week. And I think I'm going to be getting another box in the mail. I would think that I would be getting Jennifer and Mike and Nathan's box in the mail from England. And so that should be in this video too. But thank you so much.
It's a neat stuff.
Yes, you gave us a lot to try. Just know that it's going to take us a little while because we have so much. If you've watched the video from the previous vlog, we did so many box openings that there's just all kinds of stuff.
You can't eat it all in a couple days.
No, I wish I could. I mean, I want to. My eyes say I want to open it now and devour it all, but I just can't. I know that I need to, you know, respect each item and take pictures and all that, and so that's what I'm going to do. But, so just know that, and thank you very, very much, Claire. So I came to see Gavin, and it looks like he's working on a parking garage. He has his school bus in here. Yes, Christina said they've been diaper free for 5 days. What are you watching?
A bug.
You watching Minions?
Yeah.
Yeah. Minions. So Jenna sent us this cake from Germany and Gavin is loving it. He's had 2 pieces already, but I've cut him a lot more. You made what? Oh, the picture? Did you color a picture?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's cute. You did that?
Mmm.
Mmm. That is a gingerbread man. Can you say gingerbread man?
Mm-hmm.
Can you say it with your mouth full? Say gingerbread man.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, pretty good. Yeah, likes the cake. So we got another box from the P.O. Box, but this isn't the one I thought it would be. This is actually from Eric. Now, Eric and I just exchanged a box, so I have no idea what this is going to be. Eric and we sent him some stuff, and he sent me some stuff, and oh, wow. Oatmeal? Oh, pumpkin spice. Wow, he sent me a lot of oatmeal. Let's see. Lots of pumpkin spice. And the reason I'm sure that he took it out of the box is because you can fit a lot more like this than you can in a big box. I don't know what, this might be like HEB brand because that's the grocery store that they have around there. I'll have to ask him. Or he might have put a note. Eric's good to put the note in the bottom after I've looked at everything. This is spiced cranberry orange. So these are seasonal. So I will be trying those. Spiced cranberry orange, never had that. Okay. This is in a paper by itself. Oh, okay. See if I can read his handwriting. T-O-H-A-T-O, Harvest Biscuit Butter. I'm gonna have to ask him. And this one is 65 calories. I don't know, I think they're all the same. Harvest Biscuit Butter. I will have to ask. Eric, by the time you see this, I will have already texted you. Okay, here's a box. Crisp Choco Rare Cheesecake. That ought to be good. And I don't know if they're, I guess they're little, they look like Rice Krispie treats. Oh, good grief, there's a lot in here. These are chocolate chip cookies. This is the Country Ma'am. He sent us some other Country Ma'am. And these are caramel latte, they're Pocky sticks, but they're caramel latte. Yeah, Pocky sticks would definitely take up a lot of space. These are orange cookies. And this is the same brand that makes, we did a little, little cookie review of vanilla and chocolate and strawberry. They were little cookies. You got them in the dollar spot at Target. It's that same brand, that Miji brand. I don't know if I'm saying that right or not, but I've never seen orange cookies, so those should be good. I liked those little cookies. Okay, these are Lucy's Maple Bliss cookies. Gluten-free, vegan, no nuts, no dairy. And here's another Lucy's chocolate chip cookies. So I would assume that these can be found in the United States. And then, oh, here's another Lucy's chocolate. So chocolate chip, chocolate, and maple bliss. And then these are chocolate country ma'am. These are chocolate chip cookies. So he sent us chocolate chip vanilla and then the just chocolate chip. Okay. And then these are tuck sandwich cheese and onion. And those are crackers. Cheese and onion crackers. Those actually sound really good. And one more thing. Oh, I thought it was popcorn. It's candy. It is, it's actually pieces of candy. I swear I closed it. Did he leave it open? He must have left it open. And there is a milky, and they're both milky, but one looks, I don't know, one looks like it could be butterscotch and one looks like it could be raspberry. So I don't have a clue. I will have to ask Eric. Thank you, Eric, very much. I never expected another box from you. I thought our box swap was finished. So thank you very much. We came outside to go to the post office and Kevin has a flat tire. I would have never even noticed it. I would have jumped in the car and gone, but that's just me. I don't notice stuff like that. So he said Ashley has something in her car to where we can put air in it. So he's trying to figure out how to get in the back of her car.
I thought she had one in the car.
This is a gift that Ashley got for Christmas. It's an air compressor. Are we going to have to get a new tire? Or are you going to have to take it somewhere and figure out what the problem is? Did your parents give this to her?
Yeah.
So this was a good gift for Ashley because we're using it. I don't think Ashley's even used it before.
She did once.
She did once?
Not a Fiat.
Oh, the Fiat. So I have no idea how this works. That's why we're just standing here watching. That's my job, is to stand here and watch.
I'll bet you have to have a car.
Now that's what I was wondering. You plugged it in, but you didn't turn the car on. Okay, the air compressor did not do any good at all. We left it on for a while. And so Kevin's just going to put a spare tire on, and then we will take it to Walmart and get Walmart to our tire discounters. Yeah, tire discounters would be good. Do you want me to hold that up for you? And we will get them to put a new tire on the car. So we were just going to the post office. Jennifer had sent me a message on Facebook letting me know that the package from England should be here any day now. And so we were going to run to the post office and come back. We had no intentions of even getting out. But I'm glad that this happened today and not a work day, because then Kevin would have been running late. So, what?
Just a little late.
Just a little bit late. And the weather's not bad.
No.
It's not too cold out here. So, so Tammy's gonna get a lesson in changing a tire. No, seriously, I'm not gonna pay attention to this. You all know that. Let's be real here. Am I ever going to change a tire? No, I'm not. It's never gonna happen.
He's got a marker.
Andrew said he would come over and help you, but I doubt Andrew's changed a flat either. Do you think Andrew's ever changed a flat tire? No?
He might have, no doubt.
It's not hard.
Andrew called and he and Christina have gone, been going to the grocery store. Today is Black Friday and normally we don't even get out. But Andrew and Christina are doing their grocery shopping today. How do you know that that jack under the car, don't you have to jack it up like high?
Yeah, take these off first.
You take those off first? Before you jack it up?
I always do.
Why?
So I won't spin on it.
Oh. See, I don't think I would be strong enough to even do that, that part.
Step on it with your body weight. Now it's loose, then you can jack it up.
How do you know how far to jack it up?
Just tell you.
Oh wow, look at that. That went right up in the air. That was cool. It's like my husband is Hercules. It's like you're a superhero, honey. That's pretty cool. Look at that. Hercules, Hercules. Now you take those off all the way. And then can I be Ralphie?
Yeah. I don't have a hubcap to put in there.
Yeah, we need a hubcap to put the bolts in. And don't do that. Got one off. There's five of them. Do all tires have five or do they have different...
Four. Ashley's has five.
Ashley's has five. I'm wondering if they all have five or if...
No, both of them had... Four, six.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Have to go up even higher. Higher and higher. Ah, because you have to be able to get that to go all the way around.
Yeah,
off
it. It's easier to spin it than to keep taking it off.
Now, when we take, you'll take the whole thing off, yep. Hubcap and all.
Well, this all comes off.
Okay, so when we take it out to tire discounters or Walmart or whoever.
Yeah, they'll put a new tire on the rim. They'll put a new tire on here and then take this off and put the new tire back on.
But I mean, we'll get that hubcap back.
Yeah.
They'll take that hubcap off.
That was really flat.
Yeah, that was pretty flat. Well, Kevin's, what did you call it? The thing that kept beeping?
The air sensor.
The sensor, yeah, the air sensor. It kept going off, but when Kevin's car gets cold, sometimes it'll go off just because it's cold outside. So Kevin had been ignoring it, thinking that it was going off just because it was cold. And so in all actuality, it was going off because it needed to go off. Because something really was going on with it. This reminds me of when you put stuff together. That didn't seem bad at all.
It's,
I don't like the
it's
jack.
Just dragging the stuff out.
I don't like the jack part. putting the jack under the car and knowing where to put that and everything.
It says there's a picture on the jack.
And with these, you're not supposed to go over like 35 or 45 or something?
It says on here.
I think people go on the interstate though when they have to.
50 miles per hour.
50, okay, 50. Sometimes you have to though.
I mean, if you're on the interstate, but you're supposed to go slow on the interstate, not go 75.
Right.
Yeah, I see you snug those up.
And right. So that's good enough?
No, just lower it down to where it won't spin. And then I can park it.
Ah, and now you use your body weight again. The middle of that is rusty. I'm glad it happened here at home and not if we were like in a parking lot or something though, you know? Here we go. So now we're gonna go somewhere. Where do you want to go? Do you want to go to Walmart or Tire Discounter? Whoever's not busy,
yeah.
We'll have to see. Yeah, because we don't want to wait a long time. We'll just have to see who's not busy. Okay, I wanted to give you an update. We went to Walmart. It was gonna take a little while. It was gonna take an hour and a half at Tire Discounter or 2 hours at Walmart. Well, we needed to do shopping at Walmart anyway, so it was better for us to go ahead and go to Walmart and kill two birds with one stone than to go to Tire Discounters and literally be sitting there and doing nothing. So we went and we got a new tire at Walmart, and it was $77. That's for them to put it on and everything. And
it was actually a Black Friday special.
Yeah, it was a Black Friday special, and they said that they have tires on Black Friday specials all the time, every Black Friday, and people don't know. And he said, so usually they end up having too many, and they have to. Did he say
stuck
that?
With
they're
no,
stuck, with
stuck with
them.
Them.
Yeah, they're stuck with them because people don't know that they have tires on Black Friday. So anyway, we went to Walmart, got our grocery shopping done. We spent $121, which you'll see the haul. Yeah, it's getting a little warm in here, isn't it? It's actually a really nice day today.
65 degrees.
Yeah, it's really nice, but now it's supposed to get cold tomorrow, and it's supposed to like rain and rain and rain and rain. Anyway, the whole reason we got out today, Jennifer and Nathan and Mac, was because we thought your box would come today, and it didn't. We went out there, we had the flat, we took care of that, and then we pulled up in the driveway with all the groceries in the back, and I told Kevin, I said, we didn't go to the post office. We took care of the tire and did all this and never went to the post office. So backed out of the driveway, went to the post office, your box did not come today. So we'll have to check again tomorrow. Tomorrow's Saturday, and they'll be open again tomorrow. So maybe it'll be there. You know what though? I'm glad this happened today because, aren't you?
I'd rather have the flat, you know, on a weekday when I'm not at work.
Yeah, we'd rather take care of it and on a nice
6:45 in the morning.
And on a nice day when it's not raining or very, very cold.
Amen.
So if it could have happened on a good day, on any day, today was a good day for it to happen. So I'm glad. So anyway, we are almost home, and I may or may not remember to check in later.
Okay, this is what we call second Thanksgiving. This is the day after Thanksgiving where you eat leftovers for lunch the next day. So second Thanksgiving is an official holiday in the Dunn household.
So Kevin checked the P.O. box today. You know, this box wasn't here yesterday, but it's here today. This is the box from Jennifer and Nathan and Mac. We sent them a Christmas box, and they sent us one back. So I'm very excited about this.
I'm just gonna hand stuff to Tammy.
You know Kevin likes to hand me stuff. All
right.
Oh, and they did say that they thought they sent us some of the same items that Sarah sent in her Christmas box, but that's okay. We don't mind. Matchmakers, Quality Street Matchmakers. Now, Sarah did send us a bag. It was a green bag, and I think they might have been something like this. I'm not sure. Anything that's new, though, you know we're going to be trying. She definitely didn't send us this. This is Cool Mint, and this is Zingy Orange. And these are all free from artificial colors, flavors, and preservatives. So, I'll be paying attention to that color thing from now on. Jennifer is allergic to orange dye. So, I've never paid much attention to that in foods here. We just eat it. We don't care, you know. But that's interesting that they don't use a lot of colors, artificial colors. Maple bacon tortilla rolls.
Put a little bow on their fork.
Oh, yum. Those look wonderful. These are from, I think, Marks and Spencer's. Is that M&S? Marks and Spencer's. Mini Christmas pudding cookies. Yum. We'll have to try these. They say they're new, too, and these say new. Well, we might try to heat those up as well as eating them normal.
Okay, this is the ever-elusive wild chocolates.
Handcrafted wild chocolate truffles. She knows that I like truffles.
Wonder if they're
there
wild
are
flavors.
Nine. There are nine truffles in here. Let's see.
Wonder if the flavors are wild as well.
Okay. Cranberry, fig, cognac, mango, basil, royal, marc de champagne, apricot, cherry, gingerbread, coconut, and bitter chocolate. I can't wait. Yeah, we'll have to do a video of just that because that's a lot of food. That's a lot of truffle. Barton's Daily Fish and Chips Pickled Onion. These are...
That's interesting.
Yeah. These are snack biscuits. These, they're the shape... Some of them are the shape of our goldfish crackers.
Mm-hmm. And the fries...
Yeah.
The chips.
Yeah, that's cool. Terry's Chocolate Orange Milk Exploding Candy.
So it's got Pop Rocks.
Yes, we haven't had one of those. Made with Terry's Orange. Yeah, we haven't had one of these in years. And definitely not with Pop Rocks in it. What is that?
A Christmas pudding.
Yeah.
It's a Christmas pudding. It sounds like a fruitcake.
Intensely fruity Christmas pudding. An exclusive recipe bursting with vine fruits, brandy-soaked cherries, and nuts, enriched with brandy, cognac, port, and stout. Awesome. I can't wait.
I mean, is it literally like a pudding like we would consider a pudding? Or is it like a... Pudding to us is like a... what is it called? Angel...
Oh, your angel delight.
Yeah, that's pudding.
That's pudding.
I don't know what your pudding is.
It says you put it in the microwave.
Nope, here's another fish and chips.
That'll be exciting.
Salt vinegar. I like salt vinegar.
Yes. This was the share bag, and this is just the regular grab bag.
Coconut ice.
Strawberries and cream coconut ice. Those
there are
good,
wrap things in here. I'm just going to lay these out.
Those look like just big hunks of coconut.
There's a card. You don't have to read right now if you don't want to.
The Dunn family. From across the miles, Christmas wishes. Wishing you a wonderful Christmas and Happy New Year. That to the Dunn family, thank you so much for sharing your entertaining videos with us. Lots of love and best wishes, Jennifer, Nathan, and Mike. Look at that. I love that. Thank you very much.
It's a pretty card.
And we have wrapped more truffles. Luxurious winter cocktail truffles. An indulgent collection of velvety truffles combined with rich, creamy milk, dark, and white chocolate. This is that Moser Roth. We've had this brand, but I don't know how we've had it. I don't know if somebody sent it to us or if we bought it. I don't know. We've had that.
I do recognize that writing.
Yes. This has port and plum, ginger and orange, fig and gingerbread, apple, eggnog, truffle with Christmas pudding flavor, truffle with stolen flavor, and chocolate with marzipan truffle. Can't wait.
There's another fish and chips.
Curry sauce.
Yeah, I don't know. Curry is big over there, I guess.
Yes, but you had some meal with curry. Didn't you really like that?
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Yeah. It's not something that we're used to eating, but it seems like Kevin had it and liked it in one of his lunchtime review meals that somebody sent him.
Irish whiskey.
Irish cream liqueurs. Smooth milk chocolate with a cream center made with double cream and triple distilled Irish whiskey. That'll be really good. Salted caramel snowflakes.
M&S.
Yeah. Yeah, and they look like pretzels, yeah. But they're salted caramel. Well, we'll have to see if they really taste like salted caramel.
Is it M&S?
Oh. She knows that we've been trying the chocolate covered cherries. A whole cherry soaked in liqueur and covered in rich dark chocolate. Look.
Yeah, it looked good.
Those, and that's a big box. That's a thick box. Okay.
These are hazelnut.
Operetta, a whole hazelnut surrounded by a rich praline cream and crispy wafer coated in milk chocolate and chopped hazelnuts. That will be wonderful. Jenna always sends us the hazelnuts from Germany. You know, they're big on their wafers and their hazelnuts, and so they're delicious. Oh, okay.
Hold on, I think there's one.
Okay.
Yeah,
there's
one more.
This is funny. Oh, good. I'm glad we're getting to try this. Okay. Here's what the deal is. Claire sent me this from Ireland, but she did not send me this. This is the Bourneville. Sarah sent me this Bourneville candy bar, and we have not tried it yet. So this will be interesting to try it in the hot cocoa. Sarah did send us this Wisp of Gold, which we just tried. And this is very good. This is hot chocolate. They're making all these candy bar flavors in hot chocolate. But she did not send us the Maltesers, which I absolutely adore. She sent us some of the Mary Teasers. Had one of those last night. So anyway, I can't wait to try that. So we won't be trying this, but we will be trying this.
Yeah, two Christmas.
And did I say Claire sent us this? Yeah, okay. Okay, Sarah did send us these. She sent us the Cadbury Milk Snow Bites, and she sent us some of these snowmen, but I don't know if she sent us the Vanilla Mousse. I'll have to look. I know she sent us chocolate and something else. I don't know if she sent us vanilla. I'm sure she would have. It seems like she would have because she sent us three, but I'll look to make sure. Anything that she didn't, of course, you're going to... She sent us some of these, but it's a good thing because we like the After Eight.
What's this? Oh, that's not it.
Okay. Yeah. I know she sent me the chocolate. I'll have to check on the vanilla. That's okay, because these are going to be little gems. I just know it. Wow. You did go overboard. She said she thought she went overboard. I think you did. Luxurious cocktail truffles, and there are... This is a whole other amaretto, cappuccino and cream, advocate and chocolate, Kerr Royal Cassis, brandy and cream, Marc de Champagne, brandy and cranberry, caramel and whiskey. Wow. I cannot wait. These gonna be a lot of truffles. Raffaello. Have we had these before from Jenna?
The name sounds familiar, but...
They're coconut, right? I'm not sure if we've had these or not. It seems like maybe...
I don't know.
I'll have to look those up. I'm not sure if we've had those before or not. They look really good though.
This one looks interesting.
Okay.
It's a fig with kumquats pie. Fig pie with kumquats.
What do you do with it?
You eat it. I know, but... you eat it.
I know, but how do you eat that? The ingredients are fresh, dry figs, spices, roasted peanuts, roasted almonds, grape juice, and dry kumquats. And it's sugar-free. It sounds really good. I'm just wondering,
I like figs.
Do you open it up and slice it, or does it ooze out?
I don't know.
It's in a foreign language. You know, I'll have to ask
sugar-free.
Her. And now that I said that, I'll have to ask her how she eats that.
Yeah. You might just take it and cut it.
It says Dennis.
It does say Dennis.
I guess that's the brand. Maker.
Yeah. Vanilla flavored mushroom thing.
Yes.
Okay, now
this, it feels like a pig.
I'm going to hand you these because they're similar.
Oh, gosh.
We got three more things.
Wow. Cadbury Fabulous Fingers. Chocolicious chocolate biscuit fingers with two layers of velvety smooth Cadbury milk and white chocolate. We do not get these here. And then you have salted peanut crunch. I think Sarah may have sent us these like a couple of times before, earlier, a couple boxes ago, but I'm not sure. I will check to make sure. I'm thinking we really like these, and they're small, and I'm thinking Gavin really liked them. There was some kind of Cadbury finger that we really liked. And this is...
salted caramel crunch.
Salted caramel crunch. Yeah, salted peanut crunch and then salted caramel crunch. I know for sure we have not had those. So there's at least two of the three that we have not had.
Three more things.
Okay, this is where that's why I saw that name on the truffles and it looked familiar.
Yeah.
I'm used to seeing it on a candy bar. I'm thinking that Jenna may have sent us a candy bar like this from Germany. That's where I've seen it though. This is mousse chocolate sour cherry chili.
Hmm.
That sounds interesting. That sounds like something that Andrew needs. Yep. And it's 85% cocoa, so Andrew's going to be in on that.
Yeah, you and Andrew eat those.
Sarah definitely sent us this. I have not tried it yet, but she did send us this. But I love it that it's a winter edition.
The last one.
Oh, gosh.
It's a mix.
Festive cake selection. Leave one for Santa. Yeah, we'll do that.
It's on the back. It says what they are.
Okay. Two festive cake bars, one Rudolph cake, two caramel cakes, one Santa cake, one Robin cake, two mini Yule logs, and one festive flake cake. Ah, I'm so excited about that because here we get the Cadbury cookies, but we don't get cakes, so that's awesome. That'll be so much fun, won't it?
All right, now what are you gonna do with the wrap? Are we gonna actually put these under our tree and wait till like Christmas, or are we?
Do you think these are the food gifts, or do you think they're really gift gifts?
I don't know.
Oh my god! I wish I had thought to wrap yours.
It doesn't feel like food.
Like for example, I sent a bottle of lotion from Bath and Body Works. Of course, there's three of them. I sent one bottle of lotion for the three of them. They don't even live.
Think about it.
Yeah. Jennifer doesn't even live with them, and so I don't know who ended up getting it, but I wish that I had thought to wrap your gifts, or and buy you, like, gifts.
Oh, we can open them.
Who are they to?
Okay, that's yours. That one's mine.
Okay.
This one is to Ashley. I'm assuming it's Andrew and Christina.
I can't. And I bet that's Gavin.
And this is for Gavin.
Oh my gosh. You know what? Should we wait?
That's what I'm thinking. And we could, if anything, we could wait until closer to Christmas and do a video form as opening what they are.
We're going to do that. These are so beautiful, by the way. Her mother came over. Her mother's so pretty, Jennifer's mother. And she was in one of her vlogs. And she helped her. She sat in the floor and helped her wrap these gifts. It makes me want to cry that you all did this for us. And they're so pretty.
Mm-hmm.
I just really appreciate it. It's so nice of you to do this for us. It just really means a lot to us. And so we'll wait until closer to time. If it's something food, if it's something that's going to go bad, then you can let me know, please. Let me know. If not, then we'll just wait. And I'm going to end it for here so that I can go cry. So thank you very, very much. We appreciate it. So this is what we do with our leftover country ham from Thanksgiving. Kevin fried it, and these are eggs and green pepper and onion, and it is just delicious. We mix it up, and we just kind of have breakfast for dinner.
It's more ham and peppers and onions than egg.
That's okay. That's okay. It will be delicious. And in the past, we've even put shredded cheese on top.
Yeah, and if you want to, you could take it. You could put shredded cheese on it.
Yeah, shredded cheese is really good on it.
Man, I got twice as much as you did.
Oh, here's Kevin's. Kevin put cheese on his.
Yeah, I think I got more than you did.
Take a bite.
It's hot right now.
Oh, you and heat. It's not that hot.
It's good.
I took a bite just a second ago. It is, here's my plate. And I think it is delicious. We haven't had this meal in such a long, long time. It's
Since we moved in here.
Yeah, we've lived here for almost 3 years and we haven't had this meal. So it's been a very, very, very long time. But it's good. It's a good way to use up that ham if you have ham left over from whatever meal you have. So anyway, I just wanted to show you what we were eating tonight. Ashley's making fish, and so hers is almost ready too. So we just finished eating, and it was delicious. We both really enjoyed it. But I'm going to end the vlog here for now. I have a special vlog going up tomorrow. You'll see it's the day before Thanksgiving, just us preparing dinner, and then Thanksgiving Day. And then on Monday, just like normal, I'm gonna have another vlog going up of box openings and stuff like that. And that's mainly what it is box openings. And there's gonna be some days before Thanksgiving, and then there will be some from after Thanksgiving. There's one from earlier today that we did. So just know that that vlog on Monday, you know, that'll skip Thanksgiving. And I know it'll be a little out of sorts because of the days and all that, but I think you'll still enjoy it anyway. So I just wanted to wish you all a good night, and thank you for watching. We always appreciate you all watching. So bye.